Hi everyone, in this video I want to show small project related to augmented reality. That means if I scan any target image, my 3D object was animated. It's like a cute project. Just watch this video till the end, then you are finally able to do this small project. Want to show that like I want to develop a small project related to augmented reality. The project name is AR animated 3D game objects. That means my scenario is if I scan this target image, I want to get like a animation of the 3D object. So like I'm taking the, here you can see that I'm using like water, rocks are there. So in this water, like I want to animate my fish game object. So for that, let's move on to our softwares and we'll work on that. So I'll open the Unity. So yes, to work on the augmented reality we need Unity. So because why we need Unity, the many questions in comments generally I hear. So to work on any modeling or any development side, like they are having many softwares like Unreal Engine, Unity, like GameMaker Studio, so many softwares are available, but Unity is like open source software and it's like a very, the interface was very clear and easy to use and easy to develop the games. That's why I recommend Unity. So we'll create a new project that is called AR animated project. So just I'll create new project, AR animated project. And in before tutorials, like in before videos, I explained clearly about AR 3D game objects and also AR video playing. That means if you scan any target image, you'll get like a videos will be played in that. So if you want to see that video, the link was available in description. Just go and watch that two videos also. It's like a very minimum basic videos you want to learn if you are beginner in augmented reality. So now, yes, meanwhile the project will be created. Yes, we want to work with augmented reality, so we need to work with something. So that's why I'm downloading Euphoria. I already downloaded Euphoria in my computer. So if you're new to this video, just open this link. This link was also available in description. No need to worry about that. So you need to add this package into your computer. Just download this one and install in your computer. So after installation, just click this one. And it will be, yes, you need to log in first of all. So before login, you need to register. So just give the first name, last name, and just give the company name, what you want. Like you can give like a student or what the name, doesn't matter about the name. And you can give all the email address and everything. Finally, check these two options and just create an account. Your account will be created. So I already have an account. So I'm logging through this account. Just click the login. So after downloading and installing Euphoria engine, so it will be downloaded in your laptop. So how to check it was downloaded in your laptop or not? So to check Euphoria was downloaded in your laptop or not, we need to go to Unity and we need to check whether Euphoria was installed or in your laptop or not. Yes, you can see this. This is my Unity software, and if I just right click, you are getting like Euphoria engine, right? So if you are installed, the Euphoria was installed in your laptop, you will get like this Euphoria engine. So then you are going to work with augmented reality. So this is the way to check Euphoria was installed in your laptop or not. So now we'll add the license and we'll do everything. So just I'll delete this main camera because we want to work with Euphoria, right? So we want to delete this main camera. So just right click here and go to Euphoria engine, just add AR camera, just import it. It's take time to import, like within like 1 minute to import all the items related to augmented reality. That means AR camera. So Yeah, the camera was imported. You can see that camera was imported in my hierarchy window. It's like a very perfect. And before inserting the camera, so we need to change the some settings. Then only we are going to work with Euphoria. So just go to build settings, and you can see that my Unity symbol is in PC and Mac. So my Unity symbol wants to change to Android. Just change into Android. That is switch platform. Why I'm changing the Android? Because of course after completion of all things we need to work with Android, right? So that means we want to build the APK, and that APK I need to copy in my mobile phone. So the same APK I want to work with, so I want to scan this target image and I want to work in that. Actually it's take time, like almost 2 to 3 minutes to switch the platform to Mac to Android. Just wait 2 to 3 minutes. My Unity symbol was switched as the platform to Android, so then you can work with that. And don't forget guys, while we are working with augmented reality, we need to change the player settings. So just click the player settings, and while you are working with gaming or anything, no need to change any player settings. But while you are working with augmented reality or virtual reality, it's very clear to change the settings. And just give the default company name what you want. I'm giving the default company name is Tech Trends. Of course, whatever you want, just give what you want, and just go to other settings, and you can give the com dot company dot product name. So here the company name I'm giving the Tech Trends. Yeah, and the you can give the product name also. Of course, the product name you can give what you want, like AR animated. So that's it, and you need to change this minimum API level to 5.0. And don't forget to uncheck this Android TV compatibility, and just go to XR settings and check this Euphoria augmented reality. So that's it. So just close this one and just go to AR camera and open Euphoria engine here. And you need to copy this app license key. So what is meant by app license key? So just go to developer.euphoria.com, and we are having two things which is called license manager and target manager. So we want to work with Euphoria, we need to add the license of Euphoria engine. So for that I'm doing this. So just create a new license. Already I have created many licenses. You can use that license also, it's not a problem. So if you created one license key, you can use many other projects, it's not an issue. But I want to show how we can create the license here. Just click the get development key and give the license game, which is called AR animated project. So I'm just click this by check this one and just confirm the license key will be created. And you can see that AR animated license key was created. Just click this one and the license key was copied and just pasted here. So this is the way to add license key, and just go here database and disable mode extraction. Just check this one. Don't forget to check this one. Yes, we done very good job. Now just go to target manager. So guys, you can add new database, otherwise you can use before databases also. So actually this database I created in before, and you can use this database, otherwise you can create a new database and you can add a particular target image. I'm creating new database which is called AR animated fish, because I'm using the fish, right? So just create this one. Of course the database was created like AR animated fish, and you can see I'm not added any target image, right? Just add the target image. Just choose the file which is in desktop. Yes, just choose the file, just open this one and give the width to 10. Just add this one. So this target image, why I taken this target image? Because it's like a very like water and rocks, that's why I taken. And you can see that my target image like 2. Why I'm getting the 2-star rating? Because I taken the photo of my image, because I not even taken the printout, so that's why I'm getting that. I taken the photo of my image from my phone and I uploaded here, that's why I'm getting the 2-star rating. It's not bad, so not good image also. It's like a 0-star means we can't work in that. So 2-star means it's like a not bad image. So just download this database to Unity editor, because we are working with Unity, right? So just download this one. After downloading, we need to add this package into our Unity software. Okay, so you can see that our package was downloaded. Just where it is, just Control S, just Control S, and just copy this one in desktop. So because just copy in desktop folder, just I copied in desktop folder and just drag on drop. Otherwise you can do one thing, otherwise you can do like this also, just go to assets and just go to import new package, custom package, and which one is located, just select that one and just add open. So just import this all, and if you see that in go to assets, you can see that all the resources folder was imported. So you can see this is the way to import our package. So after importing, so we need to download 3D model, right? So for that guys, I want to download the 3D fish. So I'm downloading the 3D fish. Yes, now I'm downloading the 3D fish. Actually, I'll keep this link in description also. Actually, I seen many 3D models which is like related to fish. We need to use animated fish which is free, right? So actually, I love this fish because it's like you can see how it was like very nice. It's like a cute fish. That's why I selected this fish and it is free. So that's why we are able to use. No need to worry about this, guys. Actually, I'll keep this one in description also. The link was in. No need to worry about this. So I'll download this one and I'll extract this fish and just download this original format of this one and just download. Yeah, actually it's take like 2 seconds to download. Downloading the fish, you need to add this fish into here. So you can see how it was, how the cute was the eye and the color. Actually, I love this color. That's why I selected this fish generally. Yes, our fish was downloaded in downloads. You can see that how it was downloaded. Just go to for show in folder, just Control X and just paste it in desktop. Yeah, just I pasted in desktop and just extract files. Yeah, you can see that my fish was extracted and I get like source and as well as texture. This is the object model. So I want to add this entire folder into my things. Just I'll drag on drop. So I'll add this entire folder in my assets. So actually it's take time to add the things. Just wait. Yes, you can see that the fish animated folder was added here. You can see that source and everything that my fish was added. So yes, I added everything. So we had every assets was very clear. Now we'll work with the animation. So further to work with the animation, we need to add the image target. Just right click and go to Fourier engine. Just add image and you are able to see the image target here. But unfortunately, we are not able to see the image target in my game of in my game window. So we need to change the camera position of AR. Just give the rotation of X is Y and just give the scale the rotation, which is like you can give 5 or 6. Better to give like 7, not bad. You can give like 8, you can give like 9. Yeah, 9 is not bad. You can give like 9. It's like very clear and perfect image. So if you scan this image, you want to get like animated fish, right? So yes, it's like a very clear, and we need to add this animated fish. Just click this one and just go to source and just drag on drop. Yes, you are able to see the fish, right? So but we are able to see the fish. I think it's like a shape, the position was different. Just rotate this one. Yes, I think you are able to rotate. But the texture was not there, right? So we need to add the texture to this fish. So further, just click this one and we are able to see the fish, right? So we need to add this texture to fish and we are getting this fish. Yes, right? So this is the way guys to add the fish, and just I'll make this one as down. Yeah, still we are not. If I play the button, you can see that if I'm not scanning this image. So you can see that I'm not scanning, right? So still I'm not, if I'm not scanning also, I'm getting. So you can see that I'm not scanning also, I'm getting. Because why? Because it should be like child of the image target. Why it should be child? So what the parent properties having acquires to the child properties also, I said many times. And just I'll play the button, just stop playing. And we need to add the animation, right? That's why it's not animating. So just go to source and just click this one. You can see this animator, just drag to fish. Yeah, so if you drag on this, you can see that here controller fish animated controller was added here. So you can see that this animation was also created. So now I'll play the button how it was working. We can see that if I scan that. If I remove that, if I scan that, It's not animating, right? It was animated for only single time. So just I'll scan. You can see that it was animated only one time. Animate like continuously. So just click this one and just go to select and just go to animation. Okay. Just select this loop time and loop pause. That means it's animate. It should be animated continuously. So that's why I'm adding this one. And yes, we done everything was clear. Just play the button and we can see how it was working this fish. Yeah, just I'm playing this and the fish was working very clearly. And you can see that, yeah, I can touch the fish. Yeah. It's like a very clear. So you can see that. Yeah, the tail and everything was nice. It's nice, like we are feeling that, right? So the river, like the fish was there, and you can make the fish like very small, and you can add multiple images, so multiple 3D objects everywhere. So it's working very fine. So it's like animating continuously. So you can see that. Like you can see that how it was working. So you can see how it was. You can, yes. You can give like this also. So you can see. Yes, this touching. Yes, it's nice. I think this is all about. And the APK was also built. You can see that it's like I got like success. So just go to console. My APK was built and just it was succeed. And I'll go to this. I'll copy this APK into my phone. I'll use data cable and I'll just try to copy and then how it was working in phone also. We can check here. This video definitely I can say that why because it's like a small project related to augmented reality. If you are a beginner in augmented reality, definitely this video will help you. If you really like this video, just give a share and like also. And if you not haven't subscribed to my channel, just hit that subscribe button. I'm going to teach a lot of things in this channel. Thank you so much. We'll come with a new video in this channel.